The obvious answer to that is unit economics is, you know, you build your product or service. How much does it cost to build one unit of that? You know, and then how much will that one unit sell for? And if that, you know, the selling price minus the cost price, if that is positive, then you have to, you know, you just have to build enough units to cover fixed costs. That's the way I look at it. Think of what you're building. Think of what your price points are. Think of who is willing to buy it at these price points. And is there a big enough market of people that will buy this offering? If your plan is gets funded and you sell well enough, if your marketing dollars and salespeople to take forward implementation. So if, for example, you're entering a crowded market without any differentiator, or if you're entering a market where there's a sizable and a much bigger incumbent and you don't have a way to outprice or outmaneuver them, it's a much harder proposition, right? You have to think through clearly how you will get the first 5-10 customers, how you become a sustainable company. If you're creating a new market, then you have to be confident of your ability to convince the first 5-10 people that this is something that you truly need. These are the benefits that you accrue from using my product, and this is why you should pay me for the product. If you're unable to answer those questions, I encourage people to go back to the drawing board. You know, if you're confident in your ability to answer those questions and your ability to execute on a business plan on this premise, then you're on your way to starting a viable company.